what is your strike three call?
Well, strike one would be strike, and then you stand up and you give a good point to the right. All right, but okay. The strike three, that's same for strike two. Strike one, strike two, same thing.
Same exact thing?
Yeah. Okay. But strike three, you get down low. You got your hands behind the catcher. All right, the right arm goes up into the air. Yeah! And then you finish it with the punch. Oh, the right arm flings way up into the air. Yeah! Yeah!
I wish I could see that. It's terrible. The audio's great.
Often have, you know, I feel uneasy in a grocery store because I just never know. I don't want to offend people. There's just a lot of judgy people sometimes in grocery stores. I've often talked about how when in the produce section, am I allowed to, I don't want to say fondle, but, you know, touch all like the tomatoes. Like before I decide on a tomato, am I allowed to like pick it up and touch it and look at it? Because I feel like people are looking at me like, oh, you're touching that thing. You better buy it. Need to put a limit on it, maybe. You know, you no, maybe no McDonald's. Maybe stop with the big size. What's it called? The
yeah.
McDonald's? Fries for everybody for the next few months.
No,
you just need to make sure.
Tis the season to be jolly. Fa la 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 la.
What are you doing? You're offsides. Now that's encroachment. Are there any other football terms?
He needs funny phrases. Somebody give him funny phrases. Bail him out. Give him a funny football phrase to say in that dopey accent.
Unabated to the quarterback.
There you go.
Yeah.
More words. Let's go find funny words as I badger you into submission. Any funny words that you have?
I love a good squib kick.
Squib kick is an excellent phrase. Squib kick. Do you have anything else in your arsenal?
Also love a good pooch punt.
Yeah, pooch is good. Yes, what else do you have in your comedic word arsenal? Is there anything else to squeeze from this?
Sit hut, flea flicker.
Yes, what else can we do in terms of funny words? What do you have with this impression that we've discovered?
Wishbone.
Yeah, woo!
Fumble-rooski, fumble-rooski.
Next to his mouth.
It's going to be like Austin Powers trying to reverse out of that hallway when he's just like in a hallway. That's
going to
my head.
All right.
Play-by-play.
Right,
Chris, with his headsets on in his kitchen, is sticking his head. He can barely get his head inside of the bowl where the apples are. I'm not certain he'll be able to get low enough to actually get one apple. It is not, you got water, though. There is a ton of water all over pouring out of Chris Cote's face, nose, and ears. I mean, it's everywhere.
Oh. It's like spearing a fish. You got to get in quick. You can't be slow.
All right, so he is he's going back in. He is going. He can't do
You're
it.
You're quitting? You're quitting.
Wow.
His face is very red. His face is very red, redder than it usually is.
Yep. He signed a waiver, Bill.
303 Protected, Stugatz. Tell the people, and we will see. Oh, wow. Now Chris's embarrassed daughter, embarrassed of her father, is in the mix.
If I'm going to pay for it, am I allowed to just take a bag of chips off the shelf, open it, and as I'm shopping, just eat it?
Want to what?
Oh,
come on!
Unbelievable!
Come on!
The timing!
Jeez. A minute. Is this one of the things that's funny here? Are you... Oh! Chris is dancing! What is happening here? Play Chewbacca Silent Night!
Yeah!
No. I get that. But I guess not in so many words.
But you don't. You don't.
I
get
do.
It. You don't. We have two different minds. I can't wait to get you on the golf course, man. I mean, I cannot wait for this one.
No, I mean.
You're mentally weak.
No, I just am. I am realistic. You really expect this team?
I expect this team to.
As presently configured to contend.
Compete. To compete. To compete.
Compete is one thing.
Every single.
Watch my lips.
Compete. I see your.
Contend.
I see your lips. I see. I've been seeing them the whole interview. I see your lips moving constantly. You'd never tell your players that you expect to lose. You don't do that. You should take that as a slap in the face as a player. You should take that as a slap in the face.
You expect them to contend?
I do. I do. If I don't believe with the players, who's going to believe in them if I don't?
But as an executive, It looks like you're delusional, well, if you'll believe otherwise.
Well, call me delusional then.
Very kind of you guys. So you guys have a totally different reenactment. Okay, what do I need to get you guys, though? Do I need... Oh, okay. You're... Okay, you're just going to be draped on one another. Okay, you're very close.
Yeah, very close. The breath must
arms,
be.
Yeah, you got your arms around each other, and Guillermo's moving his face away because I think he fears your scalding hot coffee
less,
breath.
A little less.
If you were tanking, would you tell me?
Tanking? What is... No. Tanking?
Tanking is not trying your hardest to win ball games in every day.
Listen, we're trying to win ball games every day.
If you trade your best players in exchange for prospects, it's unlikely you're going to win more games in the immediate future.
Let me help you out. When you take the field, you have an opportunity to win each and every day. Each and every day.
He ate our seafood. Billy, 5 minute major. Get out of here. 5 minute major. Out of here.
Get out of here.
Get out of here.
Yeah, where's Robert and Kirk?
I love that, man.
Fat Rob.
Fat Rob.
Your limited Fats and Info's limited fake J. Gruden. It's just too obscure.
Very limited.
Where's Robert? Where's Kirk?
Wait a minute. Why is he? He doesn't know where they are? Like, that's all you've got?
Where they at, man?
Okay.
I'll help you look for him, man.
Robert.
Kirk.
So wait a minute.
Robert. Kirk. I should hold a camp, man, to find your quarterback. I love that game. Hey, you count, okay? I'm going to go run.
One, two, three.
Don't forget about four. I love four.
Four, Robert.
Robert. I'm out here playing with your quarterbacks, man.
Ready or not, man. Here I come.
Try to not look under the...
Hey, I see you, man. Tag, man. Hear it.
Who'd you see? Who'd you see? Fat Rob?
Fat Rob.
Yeah, okay. So stupid. Oh, let's go ahead and do it out there. Chris and Greg have begun, and now and Chris's butt is a little too high. He needs a little too much help. He is. Flatten that out, Mike. You got to flatten that out.
Yep. I'm going to go with Chris here, though, only because this is Greg's second go-around.
But it's Chris's, too.
Well, Greg's a bit older. Miles on the arms. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, he did put the bow and elbow. He told us that earlier.
I can't believe that Greg Cote initially did 2.5 minutes at that. And I feel like the country at large here listening to me, I feel like the country sides with me on this is harder than you guys are making this look.
Greg's form is really good, especially compared to Chris's. Chris is still a little high in the butt area. More like
he's wearing boat shoes, he's wearing shorts, and he's wearing a collared shirt. Mike.
Chris is done.
Wow. He's done.
Oh my God.
This is worse than the first time.
Greg's still going even though Chris dropped out. Greg,
go for Billy now. Go for 4 minutes. Let's go.
Greg,
set the record. Keep going.
141.
What are you proclaiming, King Roy?
The proclamation is no days off.
Terry Bollea. That's right.
Yeah. You're suspended for seeing the N-word in a sex tape. And the WWE has recently reinstated him to the Hall of Fame.
Cannonball!
Was I supposed to know that something was right? Oh, baby, I shouldn't have let you go.
Into the microphone, Roy. Come on.
Into the mic, bro. Let's go.
I need to see the lyrics. Sorry.
Well, take the microphone with you.
How you want it to be. Tell me, baby.
Yeah.
Because I need to know now. Because my loneliness
this is your go-to?
Is killing me.
And
I'm a
that's so fast.
Into the microphone.
I still can't believe. Still believe.
This is your go-to?
I do. On my mind. Give me a sign. Hit me, baby, one more time.
Wow, that's it?
That was pretty terrible.
Yeah.
I used to think that I could not go on. And life was nothing but an awful song.
His voice isn't bad.
I know.
But now I know the meaning of true love.
Put one hand on an earphone.
I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. If I can see it,
woo, woo.
Then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly.
Yeah.
Woo!
What do you mean by flight, exactly?
Silence!
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 Chris Cote's fake DJ Khaled.
And now, another one of these SportsCenter updates. Joel Embiid will not play in Game 1 against the Miami Heat.
I like that.
Mike Wallace will have a chance to earn $585,000 if he weighs less than 250 pounds at Eagles camp. He currently weighs 200 pounds. Chef D, what's for breakfast? And finally, a fun trip to the beach took an odd turn for an 11-year-old boy in Southern California. Crazy story alert. The boy suffered what appeared to be a minor injury after scuffing his elbow on a rock and causing a blister. The blister kept getting worse and the boy got it checked out. The blister was actually a snail living under his skin. I told you, crazy story alert.
Thank you, DJ Khaled.
Looking great at your special event or wedding has never been easier than with the blacktux.com. They're loyal.
Now, it is Wednesday, and I am looking in our studio, and I am asking, when does it end? Because I have the incongruent images of Chris Cote in a ridiculous car battery costume, dancing happily. He will ask all our guests today some awful car-specific pun while in that costume. Is it hot in there, Chris?
You need to pump the brakes on the negative attitude, all right? I am revved up for today's show. Let's do it! All
right. All right, don't use all of your material yet.
Guys, this is just a speed bump, all right? We're going to get through this.
I have
being a real negative charge right now, all right? We're going to need a positive charge from you.
All right, I'm all week.
Oh, we're past advanced. We should, even though it's advanced auto parts, thank you so much for our great sponsor.
Good job.
You apologize?
Who do I have to go after?
Is your check engine light on?
You're really still here? With us. How hot are you?
I just changed my AC filter, so I'm good to go.
Oh, for the love
Revin
of God.
Revin hot.
All right, get out of here. What, Chris?
Really feeling the tire pressure today, Dan.
Just get out of here.
Hey, Chris. This place is so cool. Yes.
Oh! My shins are tired.
It's a big day at the Grid of Death. The Flying Bucket helmet has finally been pulled. Chris Cote has to serve an automatic death, but he gets all the money accrued
for fines
over the course of the year. It took a while for this. I think a full calendar year.
We don't care. Hundreds.
How much money is that?
Lots of Benjamins. 20s. And there's more down here.
So what are we estimating? Last time we counted, it was what, 750?
Yeah, I would say that's about what it's at, in that range. I'll give you a total once I just made it rain.
I think all that's left is pretty much shirtless stuff.
So if a friend of mine were to go to Publix and grab an empanada, and it costs like $1.79, and then he strolls around Publix, and he spends like over $100 of groceries, but I eat that empanada, and I forget to put the empanada wrapping with the price thing.
You've stolen.
I forgot. No, I didn't. My friend who told me about this. I'm just saying, like, is that stealing? If I'm spending over $100
yes,
at Publix.
Yes, it's not stealing.
Yes,
no.
Of course, it's stealing.
You're spending over $100.
Thank you, Stugatz, Chris. Seriously? Honestly?
Oh, my God. No. I was here earlier. This is a Starbucks. I saw Kevin Nagani here. I talked to him. He's amazing. He's so nice. This is where I saw Steve Levy. Right here, he was in the salad line. I believe he got a buffalo chicken salad with a tomato and carrots. Not that I was being totally creepy, but I think that's what he was ordering. No, they don't just have regular cereal. They have cinnamon Chex. Cinnamon Chex. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me, Bristol? What's next? What's next?
This is not what I signed up for. I thought I was going to be eating all these items individually.
Like an omelet?
Little scramby eggs right here, little cottage cheese.
This is why Stugat said be careful what you say.
Yep. Because there's like a brown like hue to it at the top. Like when I shake it around, it just moves as one cohesive unit.
Right. But why are you lashing out at Dan for putting the pressure on you? You offered to do this.
We're just doing radio here. I didn't think I'm all actually right. going to have to drink this.
All right. So is it at this point, is it like a slap? Slab of tofu is
it's a piece of pie at this point.
So wait a minute. So it's like Jello. It's like something Jello-y. Are
something
you gonna
brown
to,
towards the top? I hope that's peanut butter.
Are you gonna have to chew this?
I'm not.
From Chris Cote, he's.
Oh,
wow.
Here we go.
Oh,
he started.
Oh my god,
he's doing good so far because he hasn't puked.
That I got like a little.
We're not even at the first line.
Oh, my
yet.
God. I just took a sip. That was like lemon lime cottage cheese. Is that lemon lime Gatorade that we used? It must be lemon lime Gatorade.
Oh, my God. All right.
I'm not going more than this. It's
just
disgusting.
Keep
it's just
going. That's not it. Enough. You got to get more than that. You still got a ways to go. Get half it.
That doesn't help.
All right, bleep it.
Oh, my God. He's doing it.
Oh,
my God. He's going to puke.
Finish it.
Oh, my God. Swallow it.
Oh, it's in his beard.
Oh, it's in his beard. Oh, God. Oh, my God, he swallowed it. Oh, my God, he's swallowing it. Oh, my God.
Oh,
my God, he's going
to pee. Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
That is Straight Talk. It is brought to you by Straight Talk Wireless.
Run harder than that. Come on, man. Oh, wow. These things are sliced like pickles, and they're kind of just flying all over the place.
Get closer.
That was almost his face. He's now got it on the board. Oh, close one. Now an exploded just underneath. Oh, hey, we missed again. There's now a crowd forming and people are taking pictures. Oh, right in the mouth. Right in the kisser. Oh, right in the eyes. Oh, hello, friend. Do you want to throw a tomato? Go right on ahead. Grab a tomato and throw it. What's your name?
That's in an hour. An aircraft from here will join others from around the world. It'll be launching the largest aerial battle in the history of mankind. Mankind. That's a word that should have a new meaning for all of us today. We can't be consumed by our petty differences anymore. We will be united in our common interests. Perhaps it's fate that today is the 4th of July, and you will once again be fighting for your freedom. Not from tyranny, oppression, or persecution, but from annihilation. We are fighting for our right to live, to exist. And should we win, the 4th of July will no longer be an American holiday, but as the day we declared in one voice, we will not go quietly into the night. We will not vanish without a fight. We're going to live on. We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our Independence Day. Ow! America.
There is a very sad Chris Cote just simply walking into the ocean.
He's taking his time,
that's
too.
His father right behind him there with the cane. Go ahead and update the poll at LeBatard Show.
Has the movie Major League...